ஓகே, வி வில் ஸ்டார்ட் தி ஆஃப்டர்நூன் செஷன். நவீன் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணலாம், ஆஃப்டர்நூன் செஷன் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணலாம். பின்னாடி வராங்க, அப்படியே ஜாயின் பண்ணிப்போம். யாராச்சும் வந்தாங்கன்னா சாட் பாக்ஸில் இது போட்டுருங்க, நவீன் அட்மிட் கொடுத்துருங்க, இது கொடுத்துருங்க, ஆட்டோ அட்மிட் கொடுத்துருக்க வருவாங்க. அப்படியே வந்தாங்கன்னா லேட் கமர்ஸ் வந்தாங்கன்னா அந்த சாட் பாக்ஸில் அந்த இதை ஆஃப்டர்நூன் செஷன் ட்ரைவ் ஃபைல்ஸ் வந்து ஷேர் பண்ணிடுவோம். Naveen, are you able to read this?
Yes, sir.
Afternoon session.
Yes, sir. Digital signal processing using Python. Digital and analog filter design.
And then?
Discrete Fourier transform at FFT.
Whether you are using a mobile phone or laptop?
Sir, mobile phone, sir.
Okay, right. No problem. All right. So in the mobile phone itself it's clearly visible.
Yes, sir.
Are you able to read?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. First import NumPy Python library and numpy.fft library in order to process not to find out discrete Fourier transform or inverse discrete Fourier transform, we have to use FFT library. FFT library available in the NumPy Python library, and all the filter design, FIR filter, IR filter sub libraries are available in the SciPy. Matplotlib is used to plot the figures. So NumPy, we can use NumPy for filter design also, but SciPy is much more efficient than the NumPy. NumPy has FFT libraries. FFT libraries are used to find out discrete Fourier transform and inverse discrete Fourier transform. SciPy is the most efficient Python library suitable for both FIR filter and IR filter designs, both analog filter and digital filter design. Matplotlib Python library used for figure plotting. Run this. Madam, are you able to see the screen, madam? Kavita, madam? Kavita, yes sir?
Yes sir, yes sir, yes sir. Yes sir, I am running.
Okay. What is exercise number 1? Program to find out discrete Fourier transform. Program to find out discrete Fourier transform. The command used to find out the discrete Fourier transform is FFT. Syntax is FFT, the input sequence x, comma, endpoint DFT. Endpoint DFT. The command used to find out the IFFT, inverse discrete Fourier transform, IFFT of capital X. Actually, small x is the input, real input data sequence. Capital X is its discrete Fourier transform, and X underscore N is the inverse discrete Fourier transform. The command used to find out the inverse discrete Fourier transform is IFFT of capital X. Okay. If you find out the inverse discrete Fourier transform, x underscore n, you will get real value as it is, but you have to get imaginary values equal to 0 for real input data sequence. But actually you are getting some j.000 something, 0.000 something. Imaginary value not exactly 0, you will get imaginary value along with the real value. So in order to eliminate the imaginary value, what I am going to do here is just I am reading the real value of x underscore n. Real value of x underscore n. Imaginary part actually zero, but it will display like that 0.000j. So in order to eliminate the imaginary value, I am using this command np dot real. This np dot real reads the real value of x underscore n and it eliminates the imaginary value, so that I can get display like this. Real value display like this 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, I am going to run this program. It says 1. Enter the value 0, 1, 2, 3. Close the square bracket. Enter. I am getting this value. Discrete Fourier transform of x of n is x of k equal to 6 plus 0j minus 2 plus 2j minus 2 plus 0j minus 2 minus 2j. Actually x of 0 first value 6, but you are getting 6 plus 0j, no problem. X of 1 is minus 2 plus 2j. X of 3 is complex conjugate minus 2 minus 2j. Center value x of 2 is a real value, but you are getting minus 2 plus 0j, no problem. Inverse discrete Fourier transform of x of n is 0 plus 0j, actually it is 0, 1 plus 0j, actually it is 1, 2 plus 0j, actually it is 2, 3 plus 0j, actually it is this one is 3. So we want real value of this one, inverse discrete Fourier transform. So real values of x of n is 0, 1, 2, 3. Madam, whether you are getting this result?
Sir, same result I got.
Okay. Exercise number 2. What is exercise number 2? Here I am going to plot the magnitude and phase spectrum of discrete Fourier transform. Magnitude and phase spectrum of discrete Fourier transform. See the input 0, 1, 2, 3. You can give any values. Why I am using same value here? In order to differentiate program 1, program 2, program 3 for discrete Fourier transform, so that we can easily verify and compare the other programs. 0, 1, 2, 3, you can use any other value. So discrete Fourier transform of x of n is 6 minus 2 plus 2j minus 2 minus 2 minus 2j. Inverse discrete Fourier transform, real values of x 0, 1, 2, 3. What is the natural response of x of k, modulus of x of k? 6, if you are taking modulus of 6 plus 0j, you will get 6. If you take minus 2 plus 2j, modulus value 2.828. If you take minus 2 plus 0j modulus for minus 2 plus 0j, you will get 2. If you take minus 2 plus minus 2j modulus value, you will get 2.828. phase response, phase angle of x of k, phase angle of x of k equal to x first value 0, second value 2.356, third value 3.1415, fourth value minus 2.356. How you can get the phase response? Tan inverse of imaginary part divided by real part. Theta equal to tan inverse of imaginary part divided by real part for phase response. What is the command used to find out the magnitude response and phase response? to not to take the not to find out the magnitude term. Take not to take modulus of x, not to find out the modulus of x, take absolute value of x. In order to find out the phase response, you have to use the np dot angle. Np dot angle. Absolute of x already present in by default in Python. But in Python you don't have the option to find out the phase response angle. But in NumPy you have the library. In the NumPy you have the option to find out the phase response. NP dot angle. So if you apart from the default library, if you want to use functions from some other libraries, NumPy, SciPy, you have to use that variable. NumPy is represented by the simple variable NP. So this angle is available in the NumPy only. So you have to use NP dot angle. NP dot angle. Okay. Naveen, whether my voice is audible, Naveen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you want to find out the matter response, use absolute of x. And if you want to find out the phase response, use np dot angle. Np dot angle. Right, okay. Save this file. Okay, right. Program number 3. Program to find discrete Fourier transform using own functions. So we have to write the own functions using the mathematical expression for the discrete Fourier transform. So what is the mathematical expression for the discrete Fourier transform? X of k equal to for the same input, whether you are getting the same result 0, 1, 2, 3, for 0, 1, 2, 3, whether you are getting the same result 6, discrete Fourier transform x of k equal to 6 plus 0j minus 2 plus 2j, 1.99 approximately equal to 2j, comma minus 2 0, here you are getting 7.34, instead of 0 you are getting 7.3478 approximately into 10 power minus 16, this one is approximately equal to 0. Then instead of minus 2 you are getting minus 1.99 minus 2j. Okay, if you take inverse discrete Fourier transform for this one, you will get 0, 1, 2, 3. Magnitude response of x of k equal to 6, 2.828, phase response for this one 0, 2.356, minus 3.141, minus 2.356. So why we are assigning this one? In order to find out the discrete Fourier transform using the formula. So what is the formula to find out the discrete Fourier transform? X of k equal to S of k equal to summation of n varies from 0 to capital N minus 1 x of n e power minus j 2 pi nk divided by n. This is the actual formula to find out the discrete Fourier transform. And what is the formula you should to find out the inverse discrete Fourier transform? X of n is equal to 1 by n summation of k varies from 0 to n minus 1 x of k e power plus j 2 pi nk divided by n. Okay, this is the formula actually you should to find out the discrete Fourier transform and inverse discrete Fourier transform. Okay. Here, I have written the own function, okay, for now find out the DFT and IDFT. This function is for DFT. The function is defined by DEF, DFT x comma n, and this one is for DFT, to find out the DFT, and to find out the IDFT, the function is defined by DEF, IDFT x comma capital X comma n, this value, okay. Since I am using a complex number, I have to include the library CMath and Math. Math for mathematical computations, CMath for complex number processing. Right? So I have to use two additional libraries in order to process. If you want to if you want to write your own function using complex numbers, you have to include these two libraries, complex number, other mathematical scientific operations. You have to include these two operations. You have to include these two libraries, Math library and CMath library. Math for simple mathematical operations, CMath for simple real values processing, and CMath for complex number processing. Right? So if you are writing own functions for using complex number processing, addition, subtraction, multiplication, you have to initialize the variables small x and capital X with this value. You have to initialize small x and capital X like this. For capital X, you have to initialize with 0 plus 0j, 0 plus 0j, 0 plus 0j, 0 plus 0j. Why? The discrete Fourier transform is a complex value. The result is stored in the capital X. And assign inverse discrete magnetic spectrum value, 4 zeros, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. If you are going to write your own functions, complex numbers involved, you have to assign the variables, you have to initialize the variable values with the complex zeros. Then only you can get the correct result. Madam, whether you are getting this result, Naveen, other viewers?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, right.
Yes, sir.
Your magnetic response is nothing but your amplitude response. X-axis variable, discrete frequency variable, y-axis amplitude value, phase response. X-axis discrete frequency variable, y-axis is not amplitude, it's what? Phase angle in radians. Phase angle in radians. So I have to change this. Phase angles in radians. Okay, you can change this. Okay, phase angle in radians. Y level, you have to change the phase response, phase angle in radians. Okay. Axis number 4. Pass pattern estimation of discrete sequence using Blackman-Tukey method. Blackman-Tukey method. Save this file along with the results. Now run the axis, this axis number 4. Axis number 4. What is the input sequence? 0.9 into whole power n, where n varies from 0 to 20. Here I am using 16.DFT for power spectrum, estimation. Here I am using 16.DFT. The input sequence is 0.9 whole power n, where n varies from 0 to 20. Navin, yaro ulla vara try pandranga yaarum paathu admit panna mudiyuma enna nu paaru instructions kudukuriyaan paaru yaro ulla vara try pandranga paaru enna nu paathukku. Right. Okay. So what is the formula to find out the power spectrum estimate using Black-Mond-Pickey method? 1 by n, summation of n equal to 0 to n minus 1, modulus of discrete Fourier transform of small x whole square. That is represented like this. What is capital X? Capital X is the discrete Fourier transform of small x. So what is the formula used to find out the power spectrum estimate? PXS, PXX, 1 by n, summation of n equal to 0 to n minus 1, modulus of x whole square, right? Okay. Here I am going to plot both discrete Fourier transform of x and power spectrum estimate of x. Madam and sir, both are whether you are getting these two plots. Periodogram is our power spectrum estimate. And
sir, already before running it, the
waveforms are here. Okay, if you delete this image, you will run this. If you run this program, you will get this result. If the program is wrong, you won't get any result. Instead of 0.9, you can change some 0.2, 0.3, some other values. You can notify the image result. So if you run this cell, if the program is wrong or anything wrong in this program, you will get the cell becomes red color, you will get some error message. This one is warning message. Matplotlib, new features are added in the Matplotlib, this one, right? You delete this image and you can rerun this program, you will get the result, the same result. If you want to change, here x of n is equal to 0.9, instead of 0.9 you can instead of 0.9 you can use some other value here, 0.8, 0.6 something, you can change some other value. You will notify the change the spectrum value. Power spectrum estimate value. For 0.9, I am getting some 4 something like this. Okay, I am going to change this one to 0.5. Run this program. What I am getting here is. Yeah, whether you are getting this one, 0.25 something. If you are giving 0.5, the power spectrum estimation maximum value 0.25. DFT of this corresponding discrete sequence is 2. Check, if you change 0.5 instead of 0.9, whether you are getting this result. Exercise number 5, FAR filter design using windowing techniques. So either you can use numpy functions cos, sin, pi, absolute, a range, zeros, npi dot, np dot cos, like that. Or otherwise, simply you can include those functions in the import library. From numpy, import cos, sin, pi, absolute, or a range, zeros. If you include those these functions in the import, in the import itself, no need to mention np like that. Np dot cos, np dot sin, np dot pi, np dot absolute, np dot a range, np dot zeros. If you import all those functions in the first line itself, no need to mention cos, sin, pi, absolute, a range, zeros with the np variable, numpy variable. Okay. Similarly, if you import other functions, Hamming functions for window indexing, FAR filter, FAR win window design command, frequency response command, all those things in the scipy dot signal. No need to mention these Hamming, FAR win. Scipy dot signal variable before Hamming, FAR win frequency. Similarly, from PyLab, import figure, CLF plot, X label, Y label, XL limit, Y limit, title, print, access, show. If you include this in the import itself, no need to mention PyLab.figure, PyLab.clf, PyLab.plot. No need to include the PyLab variable before these functions. Okay. So, exercise number 5 is the FIR filter, low pass FIR filter design. Using windowing technique. Okay, in the program itself, below in the command lines, I have given the sample values for the filter order, cutoff frequency, sampling frequency, analog cutoff frequency, analog sampling frequency. You should get this result. Right, filter impulse response equal to this value. Normalize the digital cutoff frequency equal to this value. Digital cutoff frequency equal to this value. FIR filter low pass filter coefficients equal to this value. Okay. So enter filter order n. Seven, n equal to 7. And analog cutoff frequency 500. Digital cutoff frequency 2000. First figure shows the plot of filter coefficients. The second one is the frequency response of low pass FIR filter using built-in function provided by the SciPy. And third figure is the frequency response of low pass FIR filter using own formula based. I have written the function for low pass FIR filter using the mathematical expression for the FIR filter. I am getting this result. Naveen, are you getting this result? Naveen?
Yes, sir.
Naveen, are you getting this result?
Yes, sir.
Naveen, you are undergoing like this app on the drive link sharp on the go. Where is the own program for mathematical own program for FIR filter design? Low pass FIR filter design. FIR bin is the built-in function provided by the SciPy to design a window-based FIR filters. Window-based FIR filter, N capital N is the filter order, and FC by FS is the normalized cutoff frequency. Window technique uses this Hamming window. Okay. If you want to write your own program, I have written my own program to design a FIR low pass filter. So what is the mathematical expression to for the FIR low pass filter? Sine of n minus tau divided into omega c divided by pi into n minus tau. What is tau? Tau equal to m minus 1 by 2 or n minus 1 by 2. Tau equal to n minus 1 by 2. Sine of omega c into n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. What is tau? N minus 1 by 2. N minus 1 by 2. Then I am going to multiply this FIR filter, Fourier series FIR filter coefficients with the Hamming window technique. Hamming window, in this FIR bin, automatically this command what it will do, it will automatically find out the Fourier series filter coefficients and multiply it with the Hamming window coefficients. Then the tabs contain the windowed Hamming window FIR filter coefficients. If you are writing one program to design a FIR filter, you have to find out the Fourier series filter coefficients HD of n. Then this HD of n should be multiplied with the concerned window Hamming window. Then you have to find out H of n. Mostly we will get both the results are mostly same. No problem. Both the results are mostly same. Right. Exercise number 6. Windows for different windows for FIR filter design. Exercise number 6. Here I am going to plot the Hamming window, Hanning window, Barlett window, Blackman window in a single figure. It will ask number of tabs. You can use different number of tabs. Here I am using some tabs 21. Number of tabs 21. I am getting this result. Since the number of tabs is 21, it varies from 0 to 21. 0 to 20. 0, the n varies from 0 to 20. N varies from 0 to 20. Different window techniques are labeled based on the legend command. L-E-G-E-N-T, legend command. Different windows are represented by different colors. This one is legend. This one is legend. Okay. So the legend command you should identify the different windowing techniques. Hamming window is represented in the gray color. Hamming window is represented in the red color. Ballard window response is represented in the green color. Blackman window response is represented in the window response is represented in the blue color. Naveen, are you getting this? Madam?
Yes, sir.
Madam?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I give 31.
Okay.
I got up to 31.
What is exercise number 7? FIR high pass filter design. So, in order to differentiate high pass filter from the low pass filter, what I am going to do here is, I am using the same cutoff frequency, same filter length, so that I can differentiate high pass filter response from the low pass filter response. Here I am going to give the number of tabs input as 7, which I already used it for the low pass filter. Analog cutoff frequency is 500 Hz, sampling frequency is 2000 Hz, therefore, here I am having the same normalized digital cutoff frequency, both the low pass filter and high pass filter. The number of taps equal to same, 7. So what is the difference between high pass filter response and the low pass filter response? I am going to check it. order, same filter order, 7. Analog cutoff frequency 500 hertz. Digital cutoff frequency 2000 hertz. The first figure is the filter coefficient plot. The second figure is the high pass filter frequency response using built-in function provided by the SciPy Python library. And the third figure is the frequency response of high pass filter using the own formula based. The third one is the Python program written for the high pass filter mathematical expression for high pass filter. Python program written for mathematical expression of the high pass FIR filter. Both are almost same. Normalized digital frequency omega c divided by pi. Maximum value equal to 1. Minimum value 0. Okay. What is the command for high pass filter design? Built-in function command. FIR bin n comma fc divided by fs. Fc is the cutoff frequency, fs is the sampling frequency. Pass 0 equal to false, windowing equal to hamming. Okay, then go to low pass filter design. The pass 0 equal to 0, here it is not given, that command, that parameter. Pass 0 equal to false, the command is not given here. So, if the command is not given, this function designs FIR low pass filter. Okay. If you give that command, pass 0 equal to false, pass 0 equal to false. Pass 0 equal to false. Pass underscore equal to 0 false. It will, this function design what high pass filter. Okay. What is the mathematical expression for FIR high pass filter? Using Fourier series method, what is the expression for the to design mathematical expression for the high pass filter? Sin pi n minus tau minus sin omega c n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau, where tau equal to n minus 1 by 2. Tau equal to n minus 1 by 2. So what is the mathematical expression to design for FIR high pass filter? Sin pi n minus tau minus sin omega c n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. What is the difference in the mathematical expression for the low pass filter and high pass filter? In the high pass filter and the low pass filter, you don't have this expression. Sin pi n minus tau, here you will get plus here in the low pass filter. But you don't have this expression, sin pi n minus tau. For the low pass filter, you are having this expression, sin pi sin omega c n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. For high pass filter, you are using an additional expression is here available for high pass filter, sin pi n minus tau minus this value. Sin pi n minus tau minus this value. That is, the low pass filter is the mirror image of the high pass filter. And high pass filter is the mirror image of the low pass filter for the same cutoff frequencies, for the same filter length. That is the concept I want to discuss with you, right? So low pass and high pass filter, sin pi n minus tau minus low pass filter function. So that means low pass filter is the mirror image of the high pass filter. High pass filter is the mirror image of the low pass filter for the same cutoff frequency and the same filter length. This is number 8, band pass filter design using windowing technique. So what is the difference in the built-in function for low pass filter and high pass filter? The high pass filter, pass 0, we are using additional parameter, pass 0, pass underscore 0 equal to pass parameter. In band pass filter, this instead of single normalized cutoff frequency, you have two band of frequencies. One, the first one is the lower cutoff frequency, and second one is the upper cutoff frequency. For band pass filter, you are going to pass the band of frequencies in between upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency. So you have to use two cutoff frequencies. For high pass filter and band low pass filter, you have to use one single cutoff frequency. For band pass filter, you have to use two cutoff frequencies, FC1, FC2. Two cutoff frequencies, and pass 0 equal to false. For this one is the band stop filter. If pass 0 equal to false, in the sense this one is band stop filter, not band pass filter. Pass underscore 0 equal to false, windowing technique equal to Hamming. So for this one, what is this one? This one is band stop filter, not band pass filter. Correct this. We will check it. Right? Run this and we will check. Whether this one is band stop filter or band pass filter. Sample values are provided here. Filter length equal to 31. Band of cutoff frequency, analog upper cutoff frequency 300. Lower cutoff frequency 300. Analog upper cutoff frequency 600. Sampling frequency 2000 Hz. Getting band pass filter and band stop filter frequency response. You are getting band pass filter. Band pass filter. Whether you are getting band pass filter or band stop filter.
Sir, I am running on it.
So this one is band pass filter. This one is band pass filter. So the exercise number 8 is band pass filter. Exercise number 8 is band pass filter. Band pass filter. Exercise number 8 is band pass filter. Kavita madam, another Kavita madam, whether you are getting this result?
No, sir, I didn't.
Yes, sir, I am getting some.
Okay, Gajendran, sir. Naveen.
Yes, sir.
Whether you are getting this result?
Yes, sir, getting some.
Actually, the cutoff frequency is analog cutoff frequency. This one I plotted for the analog cutoff frequency. Actually, the analog cutoff frequency is 300. Around 300 hertz, you are getting some 0.7. Maximum value is around some 1 something. Around 0.7, 1 by root 2, approximately you will get some 0.6 something. You are getting some 0.9 value. 1 by root 2, this you are getting some around 0.6 something like this. For upper cutoff frequency is 600 hertz, you are getting some value 0.6 like this. You are getting this value. Maximum value is this one. This value divided by root 2, you will get this value. This value. Maximum value divided by root 2, you will get this value. Half power gain value. Right? Present it, you will get approximately cutoff frequency equal to lower cutoff frequency equal to 300 hertz, upper cutoff frequency equal to 600 hertz. Okay. Run exercise number 9. Why I am using same filter order and cutoff frequency, sampling frequency, in order to differentiate band pass filter and band stop filter. Okay. So if you provide same filter order, same cutoff frequency, and same sampling frequency, then only you can differentiate band pass filter and band stop filter. Filter order 31, cutoff frequency 300, 600, whether you are getting this result. Mano, Santosh, Santosh, first one is first figure shows the filter taps, filter coefficients, and the second figure shows the frequency response of band stop FIR filter using built-in function. Third one is the frequency response of band stop FIR filter using own formula based. So the maximum value is 1. 1 by root 2 you will get half power, half cutoff frequencies, gain correspond to the cutoff frequencies. So you will get approximately 0.7. For that this you will get if you multiply this this one you will this one is digital. Okay, if you multiply this analog cutoff frequency you will get some 0.3 and 300 hertz to 600 hertz. Corresponding digital normalized digital cutoff frequency 0.152. 0.3. Analog cutoff frequency 300 Hz to 600 Hz. Corresponding normalized digital cutoff frequency 300 Hz. Corresponding normalized digital cutoff frequency 0.15. For 600 Hz, corresponding normalized cutoff frequency 0.3. Okay. Now, what is the difference in band stop filter from band stop filter? Mathematical formula, band stop filter design formula, and a band pass filter design formula. What is the difference in the band pass filter design formula and band stop filter design formula? This one is the formula to design a band stop filter. Sin pi n minus tau minus sin omega c2 n minus tau minus sin omega c1 n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. Since band pass filter and band stop filter for the same cutoff frequency and the same filter order, they both are mirror image of band pass filter is the mirror image of the band stop filter. Band stop filter is the mirror image of the band pass filter for the same cutoff frequency and the same filter order. So what should be the mathematical formula for band pass filter to remove sin pi n minus tau and remove minus in front of this one? So what should be the expression for the band pass filter design? Sin omega c to n minus tau minus sin omega c 1 n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. This should be the formula for band pass filter design. Plus sin omega c t n minus 2 minus sin omega c 1 n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. We are going to check the mathematical formula for band pass filter design. This one is the formula for band pass filter design. Sin omega c to plus in front of plus sin omega c to n minus tau minus sin omega c 1 n minus tau divided by pi into n minus tau. Okay. So band pass filter is the mirror image of the band stop filter, and band stop filter is the mirror image of the band pass filter. Okay. For the same normalized cutoff frequencies under same filter order. Same filter order. SS number 9, okay, band stop filter. For band stop filter, here you don't have the pass underscore 0 equal to false parameter. The pass underscore 0 parameter is for band pass filter only. For band stop filter, if you remove this, remove that parameter, you feed two cutoff frequencies, the automatically this function design a band stop filter. So what are the parameters you have to feed? Filter order, upper lower cutoff frequency, upper cutoff frequency, window equal to Hamming. If you feed pass underscore 0 equal to false parameter, then this function design a band pass filter. Band pass filter. Then IER filter, analog and digital Butterworth IER low pass filter design. What is the command used to design an IER filter? IER filter, filter order, comma, cutoff frequency, type of filter, low pass filter, whether it is analog filter or digital filter. If it is analog filter, give the assigned analog parameter value equal to 2. F type is equal to better, whether it is a Chebyshev filter or Butterworth filter or elliptical filter. Which filter you want to design, IR filter you want to design, you have to give corresponding, you have to assign corresponding string to the F type. If you want to design a Chebyshev filter, give Chebby 1 or Chebby 2. If you want to design an elliptic filter, elliptic. F type equal to elliptic, right? Here I am going to design a Butterworth filter. So assign F type is equal to butter. Here I am going to design analog IR filter. So assign analog equal to analog parameter equal to 2. Here I am going to design a low pass Butterworth IR filter. B type equal to low. 3 is the filter order. 50 is the analog cutoff frequency. Okay. F E R E Q Z design a generate the frequency response of the digital filter. What is F R E Q S? If you put Z, this will find out the frequency response of the digital IR filter. Digital filter F E R E Q S. This one generate the frequency response of the analog filter. Run this. Here all the parameters are already fit in the program itself. No need to give the value separately. So this one is the H of S value, Butterworth IR analog filter, low pass filter frequency response. Okay, so what is the value of cutoff frequency? 30 hertz. This one is 10, 20, 30. Okay, we will get approximately minus 3 dB around 30 here. Okay, frequency in hertz, amplitude in dB. Okay, this one is the frequency response of analog IR Butterworth filter. This one is the frequency response of digital IR Butterworth filter. Okay, digital IR Butterworth filter. Okay, amplitude in dB or magnitude in dB, normalized digital frequency, digital IR Butterworth filter. Okay, so what is the command used to generate frequency response for analog filter? FREQS. What is the command used to generate the frequency response for the digital IR filter? FREQZ. Okay, we will check this. Right, see this. FREQZ generate frequency response of the digital filter. FREQS generates the frequency response of the analog filter. If you want to design a digital filter, what you have to do? Same filter order, and you have to divide this analog cutoff frequency by sampling frequency FS, and assign, if you want to design a low pass filter, assign B type equal to low. If you want to design a butter filter, F type equal to butter. If you want to generate the output transfer function, output equal to S0S. Okay, if you want to design a digital Butterworth filter, assign analog equal to false. So you have to change, no need for this one. And this one is an additional, if you want to design the filter transfer function, you can use this. Otherwise, no need. Right? So what is the main difference in the commands between the analog filter, IR filter design, and digital filter, IR filter design? Go and see, check this. Filter order 3. 50 analog cutoff frequency, B type equal to low, analog equal to true, F type equal to butter. If you want to design for the same digital IR filter for the same specification, filter order 3, comma, you have to divide this analog cutoff frequency by sampling frequency, F50 divided by FS, B type equal to low, analog equal to assign false. Go and check it. Check the commands for digital IR filter. Signal 3 comma analog cutoff frequency divided by sampling frequency, 50 divided by FS comma B type equal to low, analog equal to false, F type equal to butter, output equal to S0. Okay, 50 divided by FS, what is the value of 50 divided by FS? What is the value of sampling frequency? 1000. If you divide 50 by 1000, what you will get? 5 divided by 0.05. Naveen, correct? Naveen? 50 divided by FS. FS is equal to 1000. 50 1000 divided by one, what you will get? 0.05. Naveen, correct? Naveen? Madam? Madam? Okay. Okay. 0.05. Okay. So this one is 0.2. The center value is 0.1. So you are getting approximately 0.05 here like this. Okay. Minus 3 dB here like this. Okay. What is exercise number 11? IR analog and digital Butterworth filter, high pass filter design. So what is the difference between the commands in the somebody tried to enter into the meeting, like Javin Vansi. Okay, Naveen, share the drive files link to the newcomer. Okay, most of them having classes, Saturday classes. They are going to syllabus for the this semester, so most of them have classes. Okay, share the drive link. Okay, to her. Okay. So exercise number 11. What is the difference between low pass filter design and high pass filter design? Low pass filter and high pass filter design. Same filter order. You can use same cutoff frequency. You can use same cutoff frequency 50. What we get 50 hertz. B type equal to high. Analog equal to 2. F type equal to butter. And for digital frequency, digital FFR filter, B type equal to high, analog equal to false. To design a digital filter, all the parameters fit in the program itself. Someone or some other one try to get into the meeting. D. Arun Kumar. I will share this try file again. Okay. what you will get. Okay, this one is the frequency response of the analog Butterworth IR filter. Okay. And this one is the frequency response of digital IR Butterworth filter. Madam, whether you are getting this result? Naveen Mono, whether you are getting this result? Okay, right. What is exercise number 11? IR analog and digital Butterworth filter. Butterworth band stop filter. Band stop filter. For band stop filter, you have to feed upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency. Filter type is equal to band stop. Analog equal to true. For digital cutoff digital filter design, you have to divide this cutoff frequencies by sampling frequency and analog equal to false. Assign analog equal to false. Check this. Right. Okay. So what is the cutoff frequency? Lower cutoff frequency 100 hertz. For 100 hertz you are getting minus 3 dB. And this one is 200 hertz. This one is 300 hertz. For 300 hertz you are getting minus 3 dB. What is the corresponding normalized digital cutoff frequency? Divide 100 divided by 1000 you will get 0.1. Divide 300 divided by 1000 you will get 0.3. In between 0.1 and 0.3, you are swapping the frequency band, swapping frequency band is this one. For 0.1 and 0.3, you are getting corresponding amplitude in dB equal to minus 3 dB. Maximum value is equal to 0 dB. The magnitude in dB corresponding to the cutoff frequency is minus 3 dB. Minus 3 dB. Last one is the 14th exercise, bandpass filter. For bandpass filter, what is the difference in the command for the bandpass filter and bandstop filter? Assign bandpass to the filter type. If you want to design analog filter, give true. If you want to design a digital filter, analog equal to false. And divide this cutoff frequency divided by the sampling frequency. Madam, whether you are getting the result for band stop filter? Band stop filter?
So, running service.
Okay, ma'am. For day one, forum session materials. Newcomers, this refer the links for day one forum session materials. Day one afternoon session materials. Okay, and day one forum session please link. Day one afternoon session please link. Dear participants, in order to get the certificate, participation certificate for this seminar, you have to submit four quizzes, all the four quizzes. Quiz one for today morning forum session, quiz two today afternoon session, right? And tomorrow similarly we are having two quizzes. In the forum session, we are going to discuss about the still image processing and video processing using Python. In the afternoon session, we are going to discuss about the audio processing and speech processing and video processing using OpenCV. Okay. So tomorrow also we are having two quizzes. Today morning, quiz one. Okay, you have to submit quiz one for the red commerce. Afternoon session, we are having the quiz two. You have to submit quiz 2. Okay, for quiz 1, quiz 2, you are quiz 3, quiz 4, you are getting individual certificate. Apart from this, core certificates, e-certificates. We are going to provide you the participation certificate. The participation certificate will be provided only if you are submitting all the four quizzes. Quiz 1 belongs to today forenoon session, quiz 2 belongs to today afternoon session, quiz 3 belongs to tomorrow, day 2, November 8, forenoon session, day 2, tomorrow, afternoon session, quiz 4. So we are having four quizzes. We have to submit all the four quizzes. Then only we are going to provide you the participation certificate. So you have, if you are submitting the four quizzes, then you will get 5 certificates. 4 certificates for 4 quizzes, and the 5th certificate for is the participation certificate. The participation certificate is signed by the coordinator, head of the department, and the principal. Sir, can you share the recorded link afternoon session? I missed a few portions. No problem. If the video is recorded properly, I will share. Otherwise, you can use you can just run this program in the Google Colab. It will automatically no error will occur. So it will automatically run. I try to share the video link, but the video is recorded by the offline by using OBS Studio, right? Whether it is properly recorded or not, I don't know. If it is recorded properly, I will share. So definitely, I upload this video in the YouTube and I will share this link to you. It is not sorry. You can run this program, IPython program, in the Google Colab. It will automatically run. No error will occur. No error will occur. Right? Okay. Madam, whether the day one afternoon session quiz is opening or not, check it. Naveen.
It's opening, sir.
All the pieces are simple pieces, so only five each piece consists of 5 questions only, so simple pieces only. Okay. Naveen, again paste forenoon session material, afternoon session materials and quiz leads again in this chat window.
Okay, sir.
3 latecomers are joined again in the meeting. Again paste forenoon materials, afternoon materials, forenoon quiz leads, afternoon quiz leads. And if you are getting certificate, please share that certificate, madam. So each certificate may be different. So I have to check whether the name, department, and institution printed properly in that certificate. Nancy, share your certificate. Nancy, share your certificate. Whether you are getting the certificate properly or not, printed properly or not, you may get your certificate in your registered Gmail ID. Otherwise, what Gmail ID you entered in the quiz? Jasmine Vansi. Jasmine Vansi, share your certificate. Open your Gmail ID. Check whether you received certificate or not. If you received your certificate, please share your certificate. Sairam Ravi, whether you are getting certificate or not. If you are getting, once you submitted the quiz, go and check your Gmail ID. Whether you say receive certificate or not. If you receive the certificate, please share Sairam Ravi.
Yes, sir.
I will send the certificate to your mail
address,
sir.
Okay, download that certificates.
Okay.
And share, using the share option, present now option.
Okay.
And share the window. And
yes, sir.
And open the certificate.
Yes, sir.